Nifty hitting all-time highs. One more special voice, Vikas Khemani of Edelweiss joins us right now on the phone. Vikas, good having you. Thanks so much for joining in. Do you believe that when this whole talks of the trade war, as well as the geopolitical tensions and crude being at 80 were prevalent, that we would be nudging this fresh high so soon?
I think markets always have a tendency to surprise you always. So I think you don't have to be surprised with that fact. But, you know, obviously the expectation was not there. But I think the quarterly earnings are turning out to be pretty decent. And there's a big shift which is happening from the flows have kind of continued to be positive, which I think is again a good thing. And the good part of that positive flow is that, you know, it has largely remained into the large caps, given the lot of looming macro uncertainties. I think tendency to right now stay liquid is very high. And that's the reason we have seen fairly small portion of the market is doing well. And that's what is driving the frontline index.
Interesting, because I know you went out to meet a lot of your global clients and large ones at that. What is the mood out there? Because while we talk about how there is disparity in the markets with the FANG companies keeping NASDAQ and S&P at highs and India now perched at highs, a lot of other emerging markets, China noticeably, is not doing all that well. Are people's views still sanguine towards India on the global front? Or are they now saying that let's wait and look at the cheaper markets like China? India will probably be buoyed by what will happen from the domestic fund managers and not necessarily the global fund managers.
Look, there is definitely, you know, positivity or, you know, a good sentiment towards India. There's no doubt on that. The biggest dampener is that overall sentiment towards emerging market is pretty weak, given whatever is happening around the globe. And India, you know, is part of the emerging market basket. So when the tendency to is when your overall view on the emerging market is negative or not so positive, additional fund flows does not come. In fact, there is some sort of outflow happens. And as a result of that, we have seen minor negative outflow in India. There are very few India-dedicated funds, you know, or India-dedicated money which comes. So, you know, while you remain positive for India, but overall emerging market view is negative, and hence, you know, we see FII flows being negative or FII flows being muted. But I'm sure, you know, as and when that settles down over the next 3 to 6 months, the tension around the global war, trade war, or you know, geopolitical, or all those, you know, whatever we're seeing today, I'm sure next 3 to 6 months they will kind of, you know, quiet, you know, slow down, and then there'll be a fresh perspective on the you know, emerging markets. And in that point in time, I think we can see fairly decent flow coming through India from foreigners. But good part is that domestic flow continues to remain strong.
Interesting, because we can't predict the unpredictable. Therefore, pointless asking you about what the impact of politics could be, because we don't know what will happen there. But let me ask you for an 18-month perspective. Here on, till next December, not necessarily this December, do you believe the game will again turn in favor of the bombed out mid-cap space, or not really bombed out, but a space which has corrected quite a bit compared to the large caps? Or do you believe that the larger names will continue to find favor for the immediate future?
So there's no question on the fact that, you know, there's lots of mid-cap which have corrected a lot, and you find a reasonably good value. The only thing is right now liquidity is not in favor of them. And as a result of that, you are seeing they being muted or not doing so well. But I mean, they are good business. Most of them are good businesses. Many, you know, will scale up and become large caps. So I do believe that over next 6 to 8 months, as we have heightened uncertainties around macro, political events, both global and local, both are, I think, is right now. So this period is keeping them, interestingly, the demand is strong, economy is recovering very well. So, you know, the positive is that. So this period, this vintage, whatever investment over the next 6 to 8 months in this volatile markets or period, would be one of the best vintage from a long-term shareholder return perspective. Now, whether that will get done in 18 months or in 24 months or 36 months, I don't know. But I know that this, you know, next 6 to 8 months vintage, whatever we invest, will be one of the best vintage for a long time to come.
Great. Vikas, thanks so much for taking the time out and joining us and giving us that perspective. Really appreciate your time. Well, that's an important market voice, Vikas Khemani, joined by one more important market voice, Saurabh Mukherjee. And now with Marcellus Investment Managers. So let's get to Saurabh Mukherjee's view out there. Saurabh, good having you. Thank you so much for taking the time out and being with us. What's your thought here, Saurabh? The last 6 months dominated by a lot of news flow. Not too many people would have anticipated us recovering so quickly. It's been a fairly good move the last month and a half for the large caps. Does that trend continue, or do you believe it's time for a bit of a pause at the larger end and maybe the quality mid caps will now start making a comeback?
Morning, Neeraj. For the last 7 or 8 months, I've been saying that we will see this migration in market cap from small and mid cap to large cap. Rising cost of money, rising inflation is always harmful for small and mid-cap stocks. They don't have the pricing pressure, and hence a migration to large-cap stocks was but natural. I think that continues. I think that continues over the from now till the general elections. Inflationary pressures, high cost of money, I think will become a feature, and large caps will benefit. I think the further layer of upside in large caps comes from the rupee weakening. I think going through 70, that will help the pharma sector, the IT sector, export-oriented auto stocks. So I think the migration continues. I'm not so sure that the market overall will have too much steam left in it. I think we are at the fag end of the overall market rally, with the Sensex and the Nifty are around 10 to 15% overvalued to my mind. But migration of market cap from small to mid cap to large cap, I think that continues in spite of the ongoing economic recovery. I think the economy is recovering, but large cap stocks will benefit more from the recovery than smaller names.
Saurabh, I don't have it officially, but I reckon in your new role, you're trying to get onto the buy side. And please correct me if I'm wrong here. But if that is the case, would you believe this is the best time, with the indices now perched at highs and the confidence of an average investor coming back, that this is a better time, or one of the best times in the recent past, to construct a solid company mid-cap or a semi-large-cap portfolio?
I think two ways to look at it, Neeraj. I think one is if you wanted to build a high quality, a long-term portfolio in large cap names, I don't think there's any good time or bad time for that. I think long-term compounders such as HDFC Bank or an Asian Paints or a Berger Paints, Kotak Bank, names like that, I think they work well in India over long periods of time, and I think now is a good time as any to build a coffee can portfolio. But suppose we wanted to focus on stocks, say, below a market cap of, say, 2 billion or below 1 billion. You wanted to build a small and mid-cap portfolio. I would agree with you. I think this sort of juncture is a good time to build a top-quality small and mid-cap portfolio, because you don't have too many people fighting with you for those shares. You can get high-quality names at reasonable valuations. And therefore, to the extent timing markets is hard, you're better off building a high-quality small and mid-cap portfolio when there is a degree of sluggishness in those names. But for the broader market, I don't think one has to worry about for the large-cap names. I don't think market timing is that big a deal. I don't think you should kill yourself with market timing. For coffee can names, any time is a good time. For small and mid-cap, this is as good a time as you need to think about building a top 20 small and mid-cap portfolio.
Interesting. Saurabh, one last question, really. From here on, what to your mind takes the indices higher if they have to move? I know the base answer would be earnings and where earnings growth visibility comes about. But that's my question to you, because where the earnings growth visibility is visible, the HDFC banks, the Bajaj Finances, FinServs of the world, the valuations are stratospheric, to be honest. Similarly with the FMCG names as well. Do you see more of those continuing into the rest of the year as well? Or would even within the Nifty 50, are you seeing pockets of better performance in areas where the valuations are not as demanding?
I think there's two big macro drivers one should look at. I think oil is going to be critical. If oil goes to 65, liquidity conditions will ease in India. The outlook for financial services stocks will improve. And the overall market will get another fillip, given that financials is nearly 40% of the Nifty. So I think oil is a big driver. Second is fiscal discipline. It's an election year, so obviously the bond market is worried about the government's fiscal discipline. But if the government shows fiscal discipline and bond deals don't tighten further, 10-year bond deals don't tighten further, liquidity doesn't tighten further, I think that will also help the market. So I think look at the budget deficit numbers, the fiscal numbers, GST collections numbers, and on the other hand, look at the oil price. I think those two will give you a very good sense as to whether the overall Sensex and Nifty number punches up further between now and Diwali, say.
Okay, interesting. So sort of more deviating towards, or more telling us about what are the factors that you need to watch out for, and maybe all of those factors, if they work out, would be good for the markets at large, irrespective of what space or what sector moves up. Saurabh, good having you. Thank you so much for taking the time out this early in the morning and talking to us. That's Saurabh Mukherjee.